Hi, my name is Billy Brown, and I'm a Board Certified Behavior Analyst with DiNovi and Associates. Today I'm going to be talking about schedules of reinforcement.
Before we talk about the different types of schedules of reinforcement, let's first define it. A schedule of reinforcement is a rule specifying the environmental arrangements and responses required for reinforcement, or simply a description of a contingency of reinforcement, as stated by Cooper et al. In their 2007 book.
When we talk about schedules of reinforcement, there are two broad terms that encompass the main schedules that we use. The first one being continuous schedules of reinforcement. A continuous schedule of reinforcement means that every time the target behavior occurs, we're going to reinforce that behavior. So, for example, if we're trying to teach a learner how to request breaks, in a situation where they're in a classroom and they request a break every single time they say, I'd like to take a break or some form of that, we're going to let them take that break regardless of if they're in the middle of a lesson, if they're engaging in other target behavior, as long as they do what was asked, they get that reinforcement. The next type of schedule is intermittent schedules.
The term intermittent schedule of reinforcement is defined as a contingency of reinforcement in which some, but not all, occurrences of the behavior produce reinforcement.
Intermittent schedules break down into four different varieties. You have fixed interval, fixed ratio, variable interval, and variable ratio. Now, you may have noticed that all of those different schedules are just different combinations of the same four words. I feel that when you're learning about these schedules for the first time, it makes it a lot easier to break down the words first and then learn how they come together to create all the different types of schedules. Each of those four words pairs up with another word. So when you think about fixed, that word is the opposite of variable. So you'll never see fixed and variable on the same schedule. Likewise, interval and ratio are opposites. They'll never be on the same schedule either. So in order to understand what all four of these terms mean together, it's important that we focus on what the terms ratio and interval mean first. Ratio refers to the number of responses needed in order to gain access to reinforcement. So if a particular learner needs to have 5 responses before they contact reinforcement, we're going to wait all 5 of those responses. Next is the intervals. Interval refers to the amount of time that needs to go by before reinforcement is available again. Our next two are fixed and variable. Fixed refers to a set number, whether that be in a ratio schedule or in an interval schedule. It's just gonna be one number. When we're looking at variable, we're actually looking at the average number. Now that we've talked about what each of the individual terms means and we're gonna put them together, it's important that you know a little bit about how you're gonna see these schedules written out in a behavior intervention plan. Typically, you'll see the initials of each word that we're using. So if it was a fixed interval schedule, you'd see FI, and then that'll be followed by a number. The number tells us how many of the either ratio or interval that we need. When it comes to the ratio, it's very straightforward. But when it comes to intervals, you need to make sure that you're checking in because the intervals can be in any unit of time. So it might be seconds, might be minutes, might be hours, might be days. So always make sure that you're checking that first when you see an interval schedule. A fixed ratio schedule means that we're looking at a set number of responses needed before we're going to reinforce. For example, if we had a fixed ratio 5 schedule, then that means that we are looking for a target behavior to occur 5 times, no more, no less, and then we're gonna reinforce. Next is a variable ratio schedule. These schedules look at an average number of responses before reinforcement can occur. For example, we have a variable ratio 5 or a VR5 schedule for them to raise their hand. That means that about every 5th time we're gonna reinforce that hand raising. So the first time we might wait 3 responses, the second time we might wait 7, third time 5, so on and so on. As long as the average of all those different ratios is 5, you're doing the right thing. So next, we have a fixed interval schedule. Here, we have the interval that's going to denote the time, and then fixed means that it's always the same amount of time. So if we have a fixed interval 5 schedule, a FI5 schedule, and we're looking at that same learner in a classroom for raising his hand. Now, he raises his hand one time. We start our timer. Once that hits 5 minutes, he can then gain access to reinforcement again after that 5-minute period if he raises his hand. Lastly, we have variable intervals. So again, we have our interval, which represents the amount of time, and then variable, meaning an average. Now that we've talked about what each one of these terms means, let's look at the pros and cons of each approach. Fixed ratio schedules are great at building up fast rates of responding and with moderately steady results. The problem with a fixed ratio is that we run into something called post-reinforcement pause.
The term post-reinforcement pause is really important to talk about. So when we use that term, what we really mean is that there is a delay in responding that follows reinforcement during a fixed ratio schedule. The size of that ratio directly affects the length of the pause that occurs afterwards. So if you have a higher ratio, that's going to result in a longer pause. If you have a smaller ratio, that's going to result in a shorter pause.
Variable schedules of reinforcement are fantastic. They're great because they don't let the individual know exactly when they're going to be earning. So if they're gaining access to reinforcement on an average of correct responses, they can't predict when the next one will come. So they might get that reinforcer and it could come immediately on the next response. Fixed interval schedules work really well when you're not necessarily looking for high rates of responding, but a behavior that you need to occur throughout a period of time. This is a great one for the hand raising example that we gave earlier, because we don't need the kid to raise their hand every single question. We just want them to be participating. So if we use a fixed interval, we see like a scalloping effect. A variable interval schedule is great when we need slow and steady rates of responding. Typically, you'll use this with a learner who you want to slow down between bites while they're eating. So if you have someone who's taking bites and not chewing fully before swallowing, what you can do is introduce this type of schedule. And what you'll see is that they will respond periodically because they have no clue when that next piece of reinforcement is going to come, but they're not going to be doing it rapidly like they would on a variable ratio schedule. And to wrap up, I figured it'd be a good idea to tell some strategies for how to memorize what each of these terms means and how they combine with each other for anyone out there who might be sitting for their boards or looking to take the RPT exam. For the individual terms, think of it like this. Fixed equals a set number of something. Variable equals the average. Ratio is the responses needed. And interval is time. For the schedules, think fixed ratio, set amount of responses, variable ratio, average amount of responses, fixed interval, set amount of time, variable interval, average amount of time. If you'd like to help us disseminate the science, feel free to share these videos. And if you have any feedback for us, comments or questions, feel free to comment below.